Just a year ago, I was talking about how the image-generating neural network Midjourney was shaking up the art community, and it's already replacing artists and impacting their likelihood to find a job. 6 months ago, we saw the first production-ready AI that could create animations from reference images, and you've probably seen thousands of such videos on TikTok and YouTube getting millions of views and likes. A month ago, we looked at the first neural networks generating 3D models, which could very likely take work away from 3D designers in the near future. And now, AI has finally reached game developers. Some of you may have seen, just a month or two ago, a neural network-generated gameplay clip of Doom. That was the first warning sign. So remember this date, Halloween 2024. This is when revolution in game dev happened. Well, revolution happened a bit earlier, so to say, but this is the day they made it publicly available for the first time. Just a few days ago, the first AI-driven game in the world was released to the public. And the most interesting thing, you can play it directly in your browser. The model is called Oasis, and it was trained on gameplay videos from a popular teenage game, Minecraft. But the key difference between this neural network and image or 3D model generators is that you can control it in real time with a keyboard, and it generates gameplay at a rate of 20 frames per second, which sounds simply incredible comparing to other state-of-the-art neural networks. And what was exceptionally generous, they immediately open-sourced the model, its architecture, and all the research white papers. So if you have some programming experience, you can run it on your own computer. Here's what it looks like. Two joysticks for movement and a bunch of buttons to open inventory, drop or use items, hit someone, and jump. So the game is currently available to the public without any registration, and considering the cost of maintaining such systems, this might not last. So I would recommend anyone interested to try it out right now. Link will be in the video description down below. Oasis. Let's press start. You're about to enter a first-of-its-kind video model, a game engine trained by millions of gameplay hours. Every step you take will shape the environment around you in real time. Next. Session expired, please refresh. There are so many people interested, so they've set up a queue which you have to wait through before getting into the game. Right now I'm in the line at something like number 1500 with a wait time of 7 minutes. So here we can choose a starting map. It's awesome, the model just launched and there are already 5 biomes to choose from. First one is Village Outpost. I love the variety. A dense forest with towering trees and rolling hills, offering endless paths for exploration beneath a vibrant green canopy. Cool. Rugged coastline. A sheer drop from towering peaks crumbling into the ocean below. Desert expanse. A vast earth wilderness. I have a feeling these descriptions were also generated by AI. And mountain meadow. A blooming mountainside sprawling with wildflowers. Okay, we have 6 more minutes to wait. I think we can go and read their technical report for now. It's so nice when they take care so you have something fun to do while waiting in the lobby. Oasis, a universe and transformer. Released October 31st. So here we have 3 gameplay examples. Forest, desert, and some kind of swampland. It appears that you can dig the ground, place some blocks. It has some kind of inventory system and health bar with food level. They also have some links here to GitHub with probably source code. We're excited to announce Oasis, the first playable real-time open-world AI model. It's a video game, but entirely generated by AI. Oasis takes in user keyboard input and generates real-time gameplay, including physics, game rules, and graphics. You can move around, pick up items, break blocks, and more. We believe fast transformer inference is the missing link to making generative video a reality. Using the card's inference engine, we show that real-time video is possible. Gameplay results. Here's his looking at some wooden block, running around. We already seen this before. Let's go check how much time we have left there. Well, we're at 9:33 place, 4 minutes to wait. So, Oasis understands complex game mechanics such as building, lighting physics, inventory management, object understanding, and more. Here they show how you can place blocks which are not regular cubes. Seems like he's building some fence there. Here they demonstrate that shovel is faster than hands when digging. This is way cool. He placed there what? A torch? Here they show how model understands lighting physics. And now everything is lit. What's next? Interacting with animals. Doesn't look much like animals. Just a pile of meat. Where are you disappear? Recovering health when eating. Eats. Pukes. Did it really look like this in Minecraft? We've seen this before. Oasis outputs a diverse range of settings, locations, and objects. And here we have an example of exciting animals and NPCs, which looks like a pile of shit, to be honest. Space-like dark location. Also seems like a joke. Can't see shit there. Oasis renders at night. At least I see some horizon there. Here he plants some kind of visual artifacts, not sure what it is. Oasis lets users open inventory chests. Isn't it a bit way too much of inventory chests? And they break apart as you come close. Now this doesn't look right. Okay, let's go and see how much we have left to wait. Well, 2.5 minutes. We have some time to read this paper. Here we have a scheme how it works. In center we've got the diffusion transformer or DIT, which receives input from user. Frames are coming from the left, which go through vision transformer encoder, and on exit from the encoder we get predicted frames, which we show to the user, obviously. It says, the model is composed of two parts, the spatial autoencoder and the latent diffusion backbone. Both are transformer based. The autoencoder is based on VIT and the backbone is based on DIT. In contrast to bidirectional models such as Sora, and this is the model that can do text-to-video. So, in contrast to Sora, Oasis generates frames autoregressively, with the ability to condition each frame on game input. This enables users to interact with the world in real time. The model was trained using diffusion forcing, which denoises with independent per-token noise levels and allows for novel decoding schemes such as ours. We train on a subset of open-source Minecraft video data collected by OpenAI. One issue we focused on is temporal stability, making sure the model outputs make sense over long-time horizons. In autoregressive models, errors compound and small imperfections can quickly snowball into glitched frames. Solving this required innovations in long context generation. We solved this by deploying dynamic noising. Here's the pic how that dynamic noising thingy works when running training passes. And even more examples. Here's his running around in some cave, digging a hole in the wall. They even have water. So he just walks here and stares in the water. Okay, let's see what's up there. 55 seconds. I go back to read. Oasis generates real-time output of 20 frames per second. Current state-of-the-art text-to-video models, for example Sora, can take 10 to 20 seconds to create just 1 second of video, even on multiple GPUs. Cool. With Descartes' inference stack, the model runs playable frame times, unlocking real-time interactivity for the first time. To make the model an additional order of magnitude faster, new hardware is needed. In addition, Oasis' end-to-end transformer architecture makes it extremely efficient on Soho. That's impressive. We believe the price of certain models like Oasis is the hidden bottleneck to releasing generative video in production. Okay, 8 seconds left. 3, 2, 1. Oh no, you have been disconnected. Please refresh the page. Okay. So. Oh no, what's happening? Let's try one more time. Maybe I need to disable adblock. Sometimes it blocks critical scripts. Doesn't help much. Okay, now, what do I do? Oh yeah, it works. Let's go. I really hope it will be a nice experience. Can I move my mouse? Okay, I'm holding some kind of green sticks. Let me find a better place to try digging. Let's see if we can dig with them. Well, it's very slow. Can't dig much. How to pick up these blocks? I forgot how to play Minecraft. Okay, now I want to try something we've seen in that paper. Holy shit, I'm spinning my head and everything's changing, like... Everything's new. Yeah, environment is changing all the time if you try to look around. I see some glitches in the sky. Oh, there's a cave out there. I love caves. Let's go explore some caves. What if I go down, yeah? And everything turns black. Will I get stuck in limbo? Where I can't go back? I'm scared to go there. What's that shit over my head? Can't see where it's up and down. Okay, we're getting somewhere. I think if I go to this spot and spin my head around, I'll be back to the real world. Okay, we're finally back in the middle of some field. You know, it's like acid or dreams when you have fever. Something is happening all the time. Okay, let's try inventory. I need to press 1 to select first slot. Seems I took a pickaxe. Yeah, he's hitting his pickaxe now. And look, digging so fast now. So powerful. Some bits and pieces are falling out, but I can't see it clear. What's it saying? Slangunal. Text is a mess now, but that's a usual thing for AI. X. Also digging good. It's kinda quirky in switching items, like lagging a lot, jumping around between slots. What's that? Stone axe? I see a sword on that slot picture. Yeah, he's swinging a sword now. Oh wow, a torch! And text is perfectly readable. Okay, torch is working fine. How do I build? So I take a block first. What's that? A dirt? So I'll take a next brick. It says walk dog. Yeah, it's building something. Let's build some more. Have you seen dirt in my inventory just transformed to torch? That's funny. Okay, he's building alright. Блять, я fell somewhere. Where is everything? Some kind of mountain appeared suddenly out of nowhere. Am I standing on sand now? New things just keep appearing as I turn. Oh, he can jump alright. I can build a tower like that. Let's see how far I can go. Well, he's climbing real fast. I wonder how far I can go. I can see a whole map down there. It's just amazing how AI understands the concept of climbing up the wooden blocks. But still, I have a feeling. One wrong move and it will glitch out. Can I take a look around now? Oh shit, turned my head and I'm on the ground again. Well, that was disappointing to be honest. For a moment it went so well and now I'm in the middle of some kind of wooden blocks. Is it a house? Oh great, now I just fell. What else can we do? Can I eat? How to eat meat in Minecraft? I'm using meat slot, but wooden blocks keep decreasing. That's funny. Seems like I'm digging with meat right now. Okay, I ate something, but my health didn't grow much. Empty hand is sticking out, so I ate everything, right? Let's open inventory. Okay, I can't see any cursor, just how character's head is falling where it should be. Highlight is working. Let me try to drag something. It's not working much. Like it's almost ready to craft, but stops midway. Okay. Session is over. This is just a glimpse into the future. Just imagine. Oh wow, he was recording all the time. And has a contest. Good job, guys. They create community to boost some engagement in the project. Yeah, recording is real good. I wanna scroll to that moment when I suddenly fell from that wooden tower. I wanna see it again. Placing some torches. Building blocks. Yes, this is the moment when some shit started to happen. I'll turn now and everything disappear. That was funny. Let's take a look what contest is there. Seems like featured videos here. Who's gonna get more likes? This is how cows look. And here dude is just wandering around. Louis Elytra. What does it even mean? No, these cows are just crazy. Just look at them blending together. Yeah, he got stuck in cows and drifted away. Reminds me of something. Now it looks like some kind of white noise. This is what I was afraid of when walking in that dark cave, that you just get stuck in infinite glitches and never get out. Will he ever get out of this situation? Well, yeah, the blackness turned into cave floor. I think neural network is helping here itself so it doesn't get stuck in limbo forever. I have a feeling that some biomes work better than another. This biome with animals is just crazy. Just look how he's walking and everything keeps changing around. Yeah, this video has a perfect description. It really looks like a parallel dimension. But these red flowers look really beautiful. Okay, what's next? Future explorations. With many exciting results, there come areas for future development in the model. Well, yeah, we've seen all this stuff today. All these artifacts when you're spinning your head around. And they filmed all of them. Like when one thing transforms into another. Can't understand what's happening there. I don't remember seeing Colosseum in Minecraft. Here is his looking up and down, and objects on the horizon change every time. So it remembers and takes into account only stuff what's on the screen right now. Inventory. Yeah, I couldn't craft shit there. You know when you have dreams about school or college, when you're doing some exams there. But it all turns out shit in the end. Difficulty with precise object control. Oh wow, he got stuck in the fence. And suddenly you see another dimension out there. What's next? Seems like items just keep repeating. And the final piece. Following an in-depth sensitivity analysis on different configurations of the architecture alongside the data and model size, we hypothesize that the majority of these aspects may be addressed through scaling of the model and the datasets. Therefore, we are currently developing this direction alongside additional optimization techniques in order to enable such large-scale training efficiently. Well, I think if this thing supports 4K, let a trained model to generate 360-degree panorama video and show only a small fraction of it to the user. Then you won't have stuff disappearing if you spin your head around. Interesting stuff. Might feel very similar if you had a dream where you were playing Minecraft. I think this technology has all the potential to change gaming industry in the nearest future, or even maybe achieve complete realism in games with low quality graphics. Some of you might have seen the recent video where people run GTA Vice City through Runway ML, and the result was super amazing. And that's it for today. Like and subscribe if you want to see more videos like this.